Hello everyone, it's Shannon with Shannon's Crafty DIYs. Welcome to my channel. So today is the third Friday of the month, which means it is Crafted by Corie's mini challenge. This theme is Easter or spring decor. So today I have three DIYs. A lot of the items are from the Dollar Tree. Remember, I do post videos every Wednesdays and Saturdays, but when I'm in a challenge, it's on a different day. So hit that subscribe button and click that bell button to be notified every time I upload a new video. So why don't we jump right into the DIYs? So this DIY, I'm just taking one of these planks, or what are they, like skids or something, from the Dollar Tree. The sticker on the back, I could easily peel that off. I didn't even need a hot heat gun or anything. It just came right off. Using some popsicle sticks, I just flipped the plank to the other side where the wood pieces were horizontally. And now I'm just going to create a diagonal piece with one of the popsicle sticks. I'm just cutting it down to size. You can easily measure this out, but I am just eyeballing it. You guys probably know me by now. I just eyeball a lot of things. So now that I've cut my popsicle stick down to size, I want to paint the whole thing, including the popsicle stick. So I'm just taking the Folk Art, the ballet pink. Again, my favorite when I don't have access to the Waverly ballet slipper. So this is the next best thing for me. So two coats of paint, using my hair dryer to speed up the dry time. Now here I was like, do I really want it flush with the back of the board? I actually wanted to elevate it just ever so slightly. So I had this double-sided foam tape. You can get this roll at the Dollar Tree. So it's probably like, I don't even know, 2 millimeters thick. I only took maybe an inch of the taped it to the back of the popsicle stick. I didn't even use hot glue here. The tape was quite sticky enough, so I just left it like that. Pulled off the back of the adhesive tape as well, and there you go. So I'm just showing you here, it's slightly elevated, and I love that. So now this ladder, well, I made the ladder previously before Christmas, but this blanket and wreath I made at Christmas. But I did love the wreath because I went kind of a pink theme at Christmas, so it already had the pink pit berries on it. So I'm just going to take that wreath and save it for in a few minutes. All I'm doing is right now is just de-stressing the pink with some white acrylic paint. Now, again, I'm kind of jumping from back and forth here, but I'm taking one of these wooden bunnies. This pack was actually from the Dollarama. I went ahead and just stained it with the Waverly Antique Wax. So now that that's dry, I'm going to take this wreath again. I already had the pink buffalo plaid ribbon on it on the ladder, but it was too short. So I'm just going to cut out another piece of the ribbon. Again, this ribbon came from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just going to wrap it through the wreath. But what I want to do, so this is a little trick. I have this floral wire, you'll see in just a second, but I'm just going to cut a little tiny hole, as you see here, just in the ribbon, because I'm going to thread this wire through the ribbon. You're going to see in just a second what I mean. I'm trying to make that rabbit look like it's floating in the middle of the wreath. So again, you'll see in just a second, I'm going to hot glue the rabbit right now and the wire together. So you see here now you'll see the excess wire. So again, you can still see it a little bit, but you have to look really closely at it. You guys know what I mean? So here is why I created that little hole in the ribbon, because I'm going to thread that wire through. And that way, when I wrap the ribbon around the wreath, the wire isn't going to bunch the ribbon as well. Am I making sense, guys? I think you know what I mean. And then once the top end of the wire is through the ribbon, the bottom part of the wire on the bunny, I'm just going to wrap it around the wreath and just hide it in the leaves. And now I'm just going to hot glue the ribbon just to the back of the plank panel, whatever you want to call it, and just to make it look like the wreath is floating. And I guess I haven't mentioned it, but it doesn't look like a door. That's where I was going with this. Now, you can definitely leave it like this. I think it's super, super adorable. However, I bought this scrapbook paper pack from Michaels 2 years ago, and I absolutely love it. And there's so many different pictures in it. So I keep using it for a lot of DIYs because they're so cute. So this little flag said chocolate bunnies, and I thought, how perfect, because the Waverly Antique wax looks kind of like a chocolate bunny. So I just hot glued it to the bottom of the wreath and just made it as super cute as that. So again, you can add anything you want to this wreath as well. You guys know everything is customizable. And in order for this door to stand up, I do this little trick, taking some of these wooden clothespins. I just take the two apart. I don't keep the metal piece. I just toss it. I just hot glue one side of the clothespin to the back of the door, and that is it. It stands up. Oh gosh, guys, I think this is so adorable. I love this. This is like the perfect size for a tiered tray as well, or just freestanding like I have it right now. I just love this pink so much. You guys have to go get it. So moving on to the next DIY, super simple. I bought this pail. I bought two of them actually from Walmart for $1 each. I'm just showing you the same size because I found one of those Dollar Tree tins this year as well for Easter. Now I loved the pink truck on the other one. However, I am going to use this other tin from Walmart for right now. Taking these, you guys know, these famous Dollar Tree calendars. And I'm just taking one of the small pictures. You guys know you can take the smaller pictures at the back of the calendar, the part where it shows you what each picture looks like. And so all I did was cut out the one that I wanted. I love this bloom one. Now I wanted to actually curve it just a little bit because, you know, with Mod Podge, this is what I'm going to, how I'm going to adhere it to the tin. Mod Podge, I find if it's too wet or whatnot, the picture can sometimes like pop off in the corners. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking a pen. I'm actually rolling it under the pen, and I'm curving the picture ever so slightly. So I'm just kind of showing you here, just like it's almost like not Velcro, but like staticky, just because the curve of it really, really helps. So here I am just going to Mod Podge it. I'm just taking the gloss Mod Podge. I picked this one up from the Dollarama. I think they sell this size of Mod Podge at the Dollar Tree as well. Anyway, I'm just going to apply a small coat of it, and I'm actually going to paint one whole side of the tin. Remember, this does dry clear. And once I applied it on top of the Mod Podge, I just went ahead and applied another coat of Mod Podge over top of the picture. I didn't let the bottom layer dry first. I just went ahead and put the top layer over right away. I think it worked out just as well. And look at that, a perfect seal, guys. So now I'm going to add just a tiny little ribbon. Thank you so much, Carrie, with Carrie's Crafts and Things. She informed me that Dollarama had restocked all of their white lace ribbon. I was on the hunt for white lace ribbon for ever and a day, guys, and I stocked up on three different sizes at the Dollarama. So this is the smallest one, just showing you here how to make a simple shoelace bow. All you have to do is just adjust it, and then you just fluff up the bow, and that is it. I just cut it, and then I'm going to hot glue it to the corner of the picture. And now just to fill it, just going to use some of these beautiful roses that I got from the Dollarama. Both Dollarama and Dollar Tree, I honestly love their flower selections. Like, the flowers just look so realistic to me. I mean, some don't, but for the most part, I am super impressed with both dollar store flowers. So just cutting up all of the roses just off of the main stem that it comes with and just putting them in the tin. And I'm going to take some more leaves from those wild roses from the Dollar Tree that we all got last year. You guys know these leaves. I'm just going to add them in as fillers. So for the spring, I would just leave it just like that. But for now, I want to make it into an Easter decor piece. So I'm just taking one of these foam eggs. This came on a bundle of smaller pink eggs as well with some leaves. I use most of it in this Easter sign that I made last year using one of those wire welcome wreath forms last year at the Dollar Tree. So this is it, guys. I think it's super cute. And again, it's super small. It will definitely fit on a tiered tray. They are considered mini in my opinion. Super cute. So for the third and final DIY, I found one of these really awesome mini egg garlands this year at the Dollar Tree. Now it just comes on a jute twine. It was just tied in a bow, so I just untied it and I was able to take all the eggs off the jute twine. So I'm going to use every single part of this. I just took everything off and I'm going to use that jute twine in this DIY. So this white tassel, I made a previous DIY. This is probably one of my very first ever videos when I first started YouTube, and I just took the beads off and just kept the tassel for, I knew I was going to be able to use this tassel for a DIY. I keep it with all my spare yarn and whatnot. You must have a yarn pile. So I'm just going to take all of the pink eggs from that garland. I love every single color, but you guys know I love pink. It's one of my favorite colors. So I'm just going to take those five eggs and I'm going to take a handful of the 16 millimeter wooden beads and a handful of the 8 millimeter wood beads. Guys, I finally bought these yarn needles because I was always using my floss threader. Again, not used, only used for DIYs. I still am using my floss threader because it actually can bend into different sizes as well. So, but for now, this yarn needle is perfect for threading it through, especially these eggs, because the hole was quite small and I found this needle went through the egg no problem. So you see, I'm just creating a pattern. I'm doing a small, a large, and a small bead, and then the pink egg, and repeating that till I use up all five eggs. So I'm just going to take another picture from this scrapbook pad from Michaels. This one says Happy Easter with a cute little bunny. And I'm going to take this chopping mat. I've used this in numerous DIYs. I just love the thickness of this mat. It's great to Mod Podge the back of paper if you want something a little bit more solid and that's not going to tear. So what I'm going to do is Mod Podge this picture to the back of the cutting mat. Now, this is one thing I changed at the very end because I Mod Podged and I was thinking in my mind I was just going to use my hole punch and just punch a hole through the top so I can add my jute twine to the tag. You see me here, I'm doing it all. I'm doing the whole step. That's why I'm showing you. I cut it all out. I'm going to take my hole punch and it would not go through. Guys, my hands were so sore just trying to even punch a hole through this. I probably should. And you know what? I didn't use this picture in the end. I used another one because this thing went in the garbage because I was getting frustrated with it. I kept trying to punch it and then I was like, you know what? I'm going to see if I can punch a hole through the paper and then just punch a hole through the cutting mat without any Mod Podge. Still could not cut through that cutting mat. So I'm trying to use my drill here, guys, too. I could have probably gone through it, but I was just nervous to cut myself. So I cut out this other picture, didn't even put the cutting mat on the back of it. You could probably just even Mod Podge just the paper to make it more solid. Yes, I should have just done that Mod Podge to make it more solid. Yes, anyway, I just knotted the paper like that. And that is it, guys. That is this DIY. I really truly hope you enjoyed this mini challenge video. I love doing these sort of DIYs, great for tiered trays. I love my tiered trays. Thank you, Crafted by Corie, for hosting this awesome challenge. Again, she does these challenges every month on the third Friday of every month. I am going to leave her link and the playlist link in the description box below. So please go over and say hi to everybody. That is it, guys. I hope you have a fabulous day. Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give it a big thumbs up if you guys liked what you see. That's it. We'll talk to you later. Bye.